Perfectly poured draft beer can only be perfect if it tastes great. That's why it's extremely important to make sure the lines to your system are clean. Clean beer lines mean better tasting beer, less beer waste, more beer sales, and happier customers. Not to mention, more tips for you. Beer lines should be cleaned every 2 weeks. Although your distributor or an independent contractor may do the actual work, it's important to make sure it's being done every 2 weeks. It's also helpful to understand the process. Anyone attempting to clean beer lines should be well trained in the process and the handling of chemicals. There are two types of cleaning methods: static or pot cleaning for lines under 15 feet in length, and recirculating pump cleaning for lines greater than 15 feet in length. Some draft systems with split lines over 15 feet are difficult or impossible to clean with a recirculating pump. In these situations, static cleaning must be performed. Ensure that the right process is being done for you. In both methods, the beer must first be pushed from the lines with cold water to start the cleaning process. Once this is achieved, a caustic cleaning solution at 80 to 100 degrees Fahrenheit is prepared and put into the lines. The solution must sit in the lines a minimum of 20 minutes in the static and pot method. The movement of solution in the recirculated pump method cleans the lines faster and must run for a minimum of 15 minutes. For demonstration purposes, we'll be showing you the proper way to perform both methods of cleaning. First, the faucets are removed and jumper lines are connected in a series to where the faucets were attached. Next, the keg couplers in the cooler are connected together to make one continuous loop. Fresh water is used to push all the beer out of the lines and into the drain. Once all the beer has been pushed out of the lines, a warm cleaning solution is pumped into the lines and recirculated for a minimum of 15 minutes. This method is the most efficient and effective method of cleaning, which is why it's an industry best practice. For static pot cleaning, a bucket is placed under the faucet, the keg coupler is removed from the keg and attached to the fresh water pot. Fresh water is used to push all the beer out of the lines. Once all the beer has been removed from the lines, the coupler is attached to a cleaning pot containing a warm cleaning solution. Once the cleaning solution starts to come out of the faucet is closed, allowing the solution to soak a minimum of 20 minutes. Faucets also need to be regularly cleaned. They are removed from the beer tower, disassembled, and hand cleaned. It can be done while the cleaning solution is recirculating in the lines for this process. It must be done after the 20-minute soak period is over in the static pot method. Once the appropriate soak time has expired, the cleaning solution must be rinsed out of the lines using fresh, clean, cold water. This process should continue until the pH of the water coming out of the faucet matches the pH of the fresh water being used to rinse the lines. Make sure pH paper is used to measure the actual pH of the water. Once there is no evidence of cleaning solution in the lines, the keg couplers are hand cleaned. This is the perfect time to inspect and make sure that the coupler is in good working condition. If it is, retap the keg and open the faucet to flush the rinsed water out of the line. Now that you know the importance and process, make sure that your bar is staying on schedule for line cleanings. We all want your customers to be happy. Serving great tasting beer is just one way to keep them coming back.